Welcome to another edition of Know Providence. This is Brad Burden, and I'm joined today by our boys and girls tennis coach, the 2017 state runner-up, Coach Scott Gurgol. Coach, thanks for being here.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
And we should just right from the beginning, you know, the reason we're having to do Zoom meetings and not face-to-face and getting this content out to our families and people out in the Providence community, of course, is the health situation that we're all in. But we should be noted that you are on the front lines in a lot of ways. I mean, I know you're not at hospitals treating corona patients, but you are still a healthcare provider and are out there dealing with people, and you can't just stay inside like all of us. So first of all, thank you for continuing to work and serve the community, but tell us a little bit about your career that pays the bills and how that's changed maybe for you during this pandemic.
Sure. So my career is a physical therapist. I have been working in home health for the last almost 10 years. And really our role is to keep people out of the hospitals. The best research out there shows that when people come home from the hospital, if they start home care within the first 48 hours, there's about an 80% less chance they go back to the hospital within 2 to 4 weeks. So we're currently just working with the same patient population as always. People with heart problems, breathing problems, people who are having difficulty functioning a normal life within their home. And we are giving them the treatments they need to, one, try to get independence in their life back, and two, keep them out of the hospitals so that they can stay away while all the patients who are coming in with coronavirus and other issues are getting the treatment they need.
Well, that's great. And thank you again for you know, being on the front lines there and working with the elderly population. I know a lot of the, you know, the patients you have are kind of that 65 and older generation, correct?
Correct. That is the majority of our patients.
That's great. But then you're also the boys and girls tennis coach at Providence High School. Tell us how long you've been at Providence.
I've been at Providence since spring of 2007. I actually started as the assistant with the girls team. And then the head coach for the boys opened up that late spring or summer. So I applied and was kind of shocked that I got it. I was young at the time and was new to Providence, but the school took a chance on me, and so I've been the head coach of the boys since 2007, and I spent 6 years assisting the girls, took a little time off from the spring season, and then came back as a head coach in 2016.
Well, if it's true the school took a chance on you, it was a good gamble on their part because it's paid off with a lot of success. Talk to us about the boys' success and then the girls. We've had more recently, you know, some deeper runs with the girls, culminating with that state runner-up performance in 2017.
Correct. So started with the boys, and there was some culture change at first. So we had a few years where I'll admit that I probably wasted some good talent. And just trying to learn, and but we eventually had a run where for 6 straight years we were in and out of the top 25 state rankings. With 4 of those years we finished inside the top 25. Tennis is a single class sport, so our ranking systems is everybody. So that was a big achievement. Unfortunately, we weren't able to get any sectional titles. We have to run into Jeffersonville every year, and it seemed that every year we were ranked, they were ranked 5 to 10 spots ahead of us. But we've had some good players from Will Dixon to Will Andrus to Landon Carrico, who have gone on to play college tennis after leaving our program. Recently, the girls have had a lot of success, starting with when I took over in 2016, we started a run of 4 straight sectionals, 4 straight regionals, two semi-states in 2017 and 2018. And in 2017, we were the state runner-up, losing to the eventual champion, Carmel. 2018, our singles player, Hallie Trinkle, ended up winning the singles state title as an individual. And she is currently now playing at College of Charleston, number two singles for them, and has an excellent record. And Natalie Bozing, our current best player, is signed to play tennis for Butler.
Talk to us now about your youth program, the deanery tennis program for both boys and girls, what age that starts, and if there's a kid out there who's interested in tennis, how they go about getting involved in the sport.
Sure. So we do a summer clinic or camp almost every year. We're not sure what's going to happen this year, so we're kind of playing that by ear at the moment. And I'm going to gear that more and more towards the younger population, 10 and under. There's a lot of tennis opportunities for people who are on the deanery team in JV and high school level tennis, but there's not a whole lot of opportunities around for the 10 and unders. So I think I'm going to change the summer program more towards that. So that would be an option for people who are just getting started, especially parents who don't play tennis and they're trying to figure out how to start their kid. A 10 and under situation would be excellent for them. Then what we do with the deanery team is usually it's third grade and above can join the team. Coach Crone, based on numbers, oftentimes has to decide if the third, fourth, and fifth graders will get a chance to actually play matches versus other schools or just partake in the practices. But we do let them start out around third grade. He runs the girls' deanery season in the spring, usually starts in late February or early March. And that runs until the middle of May. And then the boys' season starts early August and runs until the end of September. The easiest thing to do would be get on Providence's website and find the athletics link and find the tennis pages and email me if you have interest in your son or daughter playing tennis, and then I can help you get the contact information to Coach Crone, who coaches the deanery team, or Justin, who manages the deanery athletics. And then for the upper-level players, we oftentimes let them hit in with our high school JV team to give them a taste of what the high school seasons are going to be like. Try to get them going a little early.
That's great. And, you know, recently you just earned a pretty prestigious certification that you probably are no smarter than you were before the certification, but at least now there's a governing body who says that Scott Gurgol is a pretty good tennis coach. So congratulations on that. And I'll butcher if I try to say all of the acronyms. So tell us about that certification you just, worked so hard and got awarded.
Sure. I've been wanting to get a professional level certification for a while. We've had some good teams, and there's always a small part of you as a coach that's like, is it my players? Is it me? Is it the combination? And so it was one of those things where I wanted to prove to myself I could do it. So I chose the Professional Tennis Registry. We call it PTR. They have level certifications for 10 and under, adult, 11 to 17, and elite athlete. And so I did the 11 to 17, so as most of my players will not be elite athletes. I will have, one or two out of the majority of mine be elite. So I figured the 11 to 17 was the smarter route. It would help more of my players. There are three different certification levels. There's associate instructor is the bottom level, then instructor is the middle level, and professional is the top level. And the test incorporated your abilities on the court, so my own personal hitting ability, your ability to run a one-on-one lesson and a group lesson, and then a paper exam to test your knowledge. And you had to get a certain level on all three. And so I did get the professional level for 11 to 17 year olds.
Wow, that's incredible. I'm glad that they don't require that for basketball, because I would fail the on-court part.
It took me a few weeks of getting out on a ball machine just to fine-tune everything. And I still wasn't sure I was ready, but apparently the instructor thought I was good enough.
There you go. Talk about, you've played, you have this professional certification now. You're a physical therapist, so I'm sure your knowledge and expertise of biomechanics helps with your coaching. You coach in a single class sport, meaning you have to play against whether it's just Jeff right next door or Carmel at the state finals. Talk about what draws you to want to coach at Providence High School.
What draws me to Providence has been the culture, which is the school, the kids, and the parents. I haven't ever wanted a thing. If I think the program needs something, people get it done. That's one thing I love as a coach, is people have my back and people help me out. I'm the one that's going to go in the record books for, the success that our teams have had, but really I'm just the head of everything that is all the people that are helping me. I would be not much without all the help Providence gives me. The other thing is, man, I love an underdog story. I grew up in Salem, Indiana. It was not a tennis school, and we won two sectionals, and it was one of the coolest things ever. And I love being the little guy that can go out there and compete with the big dogs and beat the big dogs. The David versus Goliath mentality. So that it every win seems just a little more special. And I try to make sure the kids and the parents and everybody knows about that.
That's awesome, Coach. And again, thank you so much for everything you do for Providence and everything you do out there in our community, especially in this time. So always, but again, during this time, stay safe, and wish you nothing but the best. And we can't wait till we get through this and we get to get out there and watch the ladies on the tennis court.
Agree. And you and your family stay safe too.
Thank you. All right. Take care.